Thank you. so long. I ain't had no love since you've been gone. Corina, 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 I love you so. I left Corina way across the sea. Oh me, I left Corina way across the sea.
Ah! Sir, will you keep your filthy hands to yourself, please? You're bugging out of here. One more. You watch out. That guy's an animal.
Corina, I love you so.
Friends, crewmen, passengers, lend me your ears. Captain Tempest welcomes you aboard this routine scientific survey flight.
We hope you have a very pleasant trip. But any questions that should come to mind, ask our new science officer.
That's me.
If there be truth in sight, she's a woman.
Think you I am no stronger than my sex?
Bosun, commence the pre-flight checks.
Check. Matrix.
Check.
Check all the photon shields.
Check.
Check the dilithium crystal rods.
Check.
The gravitational resistors.
Check.
And now check all the audio visual screens.
Two parents, both alike in dignity, in outer space, where we are paylocate, from ancient grudge, break to new mutiny, and on forbidden planet meet their fate. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a lovely star-born daughter takes her life, whose teenage crush and adolescent woes do drive her father mad and end his life. The fearful passage of his death-marked love and the continuance of her mother's rage, which but a monstrous end naught could remove, is now the 2 hours traffic of our stage. The which, if you with patient ears attend, what here shall miss, our toil shall strive to mend.
We have completed all the pre-flight checks.
Commence countdown.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Ignition.
all hail and welcome each and every one. Thank you for traveling with us today on Interplanetary Space Flight 9. We're cruising now out into hyperspace, and as the captain has switched off the sign, you may, of course, unclasp your safety belts. Thank you.
Look to the baked beans. Spare enough for the cast. Bosun.
Aye, sir.
Make haste and take the bridge. Yon woman has a mean and hungry look. She thinks too much. Women are dangerous.
Fear her not, Captain. She's not dangerous. She's a noble doctor and well given.
Would she were flatter, but I fear her not. Yet, if my name were liable to fear, I do not know the woman I'd avoid so soon as that science officer. She reads much, she is a great observer, and she sees quite through the deeds of men. Women, you see, are never at heart's ease whilst they behold a greater than themselves, and therefore are they very dangerous.
I grant I am a woman. That's not all. A woman and a mother and a wife. I grant I am a woman, but with all a woman well respected, it's on file.
Fie, unknit that threatening and unkind brow, and dart not scornful glances from those eyes. A woman moved is like a fountain troubled, muddy, ill-seamed, thick, bereft of beauty. Why are your bodies soft and weak and smooth? Unapt for toil and trouble in this world, but that your soft conditions and your hearts should well agree with your external parts.
Come, come, you froward and unable worm. My mind has been as big as one of yours, my heart as great, my IQ happily more.
I am ashamed that, doctor, you're so simple to offer war when you should kneel for peace.
What rhubarb, senna, or purgative drugs would drive these dull thoughts hence? Misogynist.
Take your face hence, woman. I am sick at heart.
Oh, it is not heart sickness, but sickness of the mind.
Mind sickness? Where did you read that?
'Tis physics, sir, as taught by Sigmund Freud.
Throw physic to the dogs. I'll none of it. This is a man's world.
But it wouldn't be nothing without a woman on Earth.
See, man made the cars to take us over the road, and man made the trains to carry the heavy load, and man made the electric light to take us out of the dark, and man made
the boat for the water,
as Noah made the ark. This is a man's world.
But it wouldn't be nothing without a woman on this earth. Baby boy.
But man makes them happy. 'Cause man makes them toys.
How can man make everything, everything he can? Huh?
'Cause man makes the money to buy from other men. This is a man's world.
But it wouldn't be nothing without a woman on this earth.
Our sensors are picking up a storm of asteroids approaching very fast.
Evasive action should be taken now, or else we'll hit them.
And they rattle my brain.
These asteroids would drive a man insane.
Damage report, damage report.
They broke the shield.
Well, I'll be killed.
balls of fire!
Bolton.
Hey, Master! Watch your
Bolton smartly. Repair the photon shield, or else I thought it's lost. Bestir! Bestir!
Goodness gracious, great balls of fire!
Hey, my hearts, cheerily, cheerily, my hearts. Quick, quick! Put up the force field.
Send to the captain's orders.
Good captain, have care. Let's use the shuttlecraft. Play the men.
Time for you, be below.
Do you not hear him? You are our labor.
Keep your cabin. You do assist the storm.
I chew my nails and I twiddle my thumbs.
I'm really nervous and this ain't no fun. Help me, baby. I'm going crazy.
Goodness gracious, great balls of fire.
Down with the warp speed, quickly. Lower, lower. Bring the drive between course.
But Captain!
A plague upon this howling. You are louder than the weather for our office.
A pox on your throat. You bawling, blasphemous, uncharitable dog.
Lay her a hold.
Set her two courses into space again. Lay her off.
All lost.
Mercy on us, we split, farewell my wife and children, farewell brother, we split.
Goodness gracious, great balls of fire.
Now would I give 1,000 light years of space for 1 acre of barren ground, the will to God be done, but I would fain die, a terrestrial death. Help me, baby.
Like a dog to shoot.
I must confess, we're in a mess.
Can you hear us, Earth? This is SOS.
I chew my nails and I twiddle my thumb. I'm really nervous and this ain't no fun.
Come back, lady. You drive me crazy.
Goodness gracious, great balls of...
Where should this music be? The air or the Earth?
It sounds no more. Yet sure, it waits upon some force on yonder planet. This music creeps by us through the asteroids, allaying both their fury and my passion with its sweet air.
Thence have we followed it. Or it has drawn us rather. But it's gone.
Phew!
No, it begins again!
We have been caught with an attractor beam, which seems to emanate from yonder star.
The chief says we cannot pull away. There seems to be nothing we can do.
Get the science officer aloft. I need advice. I haven't got a plan.
She's gone, sir. Taking our last shuttlecraft. And now it's just a blip upon the screen.
It's court-martial if ever she is found.
But, sir, I can't believe it's cowardice.
Speak not you for her! She's a traitor!
Cripes!
What planet friend is this?
Deliria, Captain.
What should I do on Deliria?
I think I better go and get the Valium.
This planet have a pleasant seat. Air nimbly and sweetly recommends itself onto our probing sensors. And I see they have observed the air is delicate.
But why were we caught in a tractor beam? Deliria was deserted long ago.
There seems to be a signal coming through upon my scanner screen.
Then patch us in.
Oh, torment, trouble, wonder, and amazement inhabits here. Some alien force holds us on this fearful planet.
Behold, Captain.
My God, I know that face. It's Prospero. Who, 15 years ago, this very day, defected to the other side, they say.
Not so, my friends. But please, collect yourselves. No more amazement. Tell your piteous hearts there's no harm done.
You'll rue this day.
No harm. I have done nothing but in care of thee. Of thee and my dear one, my daughter, who is ignorant of what I am, not knowing of whence I came, nor that I am more better than Prospero, master of the full poor cell, and her no greater father. Hey, man, do you understand me now? If sometimes I seem a little mad. Oh, but don't you know that no one alive always be an angel? When things go wrong, I seem to be bad. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh, Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Quit stalling, Prospero, and tell us straight. For what vile scheme you brought us here?
'Tis time I should inform thee further. Lend an ear. My wife and lab assistant, Gloria, I pray you mark me, that a mother should be so perfidious. She, next to my child, of all the world I love, and to her put the manager of my lab, as at that time, through all the subsidies, it was the first, and Prospero the tops, being so reputed in dignity and scientific art, without a parallel. Now these, being all my study, the government had set me on a project, and I had nearly cracked it, being transported and wrapped in secret studies. Then, my wife, dost thou attend me?
Sir, most heedfully.
I thus neglected worldly aims, all dedicate to closeness and the bettering of the mind. I cannot tell what happened to my wife, but something evil grew within her breast. And just as we, the project, did complete, she stuck me up and bound me hands and feet.
Wherefore did she not that hour destroy you?
Well demanded, sir. My tale provokes that question. Sir, she dare not. In view, she hurried me aboard a craft, a rotten carcass of a satellite, with very little hope I should survive. And launched this spaceship through the galaxy. In this ship, my infant daughter slept. Because of savings I had tried to fight, the lab had axed its crash facility. This was the most unkindest cut of all.
A tragic tale, and most inglorious fall.
If I see Betty, I want you to know I never meant to take it out. Life has its problems, and I've had my share. But that's one thing I never mean to do. Hey, man, don't you know I'm human? I have thoughts like any other one. Oh, but sometimes I find myself long regretting some foolish thing, some little simple thing. And but I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh, Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood. Yes, I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Misunderstood.
Oh, never was a story of more woe than this of Gloria and Prospero.
At last, though long, you've come to rescue me. And though I had to bring your ship down, sir, that smile at escapes and perils overblown. Please, honored captain, I do bid you welcome.
While I with self-same kindness welcome you. Feast with the best and welcome to my ship. We'll banquet now to close our stomachs up. After initial fears. Here you come in. Now we need to chat, as well as eat.
Nothing but sit in ship and eat and eat.
Avaunt and quit my sight. Let the earth hide thee. Thy bones are marrowless. Thy blood is cold. Thou hast no speculation in those eyes which thou dost glare with.
Think of this, friend. But as a thing of metal, 'tis no other.
That thing ain't human, sir. It frightens me.
But he is friendly. He does make our fires, fetch in our wood, and serves in offices that profit us. His name is Ariel. Now, robot. Speak.
There's one enough within. Hi, cats. My name is Ariel. Beep, beep. I'm the invention of the doctor. Who took pains to make me speak. He taught me each hour one thing or other. Well, like, that's not known. I know meaning. But with gabble, like a thing most brutish. Yo, hey.
You are most welcome. Cookie, go below. Fetch yourself food. And be quick. Thou art best to answer other business.
Shrugst thou, malice?
Thou neglect'st or dost unwillingly what we command? I'll put you in the brig!
Hey.
Good Dr. Prospero, before we leave, we have a problem.
Yes, of this we know. You need to find your science officer who fled your spaceship in its hour of need. I tracked her on my radar screen until she dipped below the horizon, and then upon the planet's dark side, vanish it.
Now, Ariel, emit a scanner ray. I'll know the fate of this lost shuttlecraft, its disposition and position.
Wow! But soft. What light from yonder airlock breaks?
It is my daughter, sir.
Jeepers. What a hunt.
I love the colorful clothes she wears and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair.
Thank you.
Go, robot, go and find this shuttlecraft. Try it missing of this company. Go search it out and bring it hither straight.
I don't know where, but he sends me there.
Sent my little girl. Miranda, say hello.
What? Mr. Spirit?
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have such.
I might call him divine. For nothing natural could be so fair.
I'm pregnant.
Excuse me, madam. Good doctor. List. A word.
Hey, Cookie. Attention!
Tell me, is it possible that love should of a sudden take such hold?
Oh, sir. Until I found it to be true, I never thought it possible or likely. But see, while idly I stood looking on, I found the effects of love in idleness.
Cookie, you look so longly on the dame. Perhaps you marked not what's the pith of all.
Bosun, I burn. I pine. I perish, bosun, if I achieve not this young, modest girl.
Oh, come on, Cookie, snap out of this trance.
I pray awake, man.
You do love this.
Check. Bend thoughts and wits to achieve her. Okay. I'll try.
Sweet lady.
Hi. Oh. What sayest thou?
Cookie. Sweet lady, pity me.
Why, I am sorry for thee, gentle friend.
Wherever sorry is, relief would be. If you do sorrow at my grief in love, by giving love, then your sorrow and my grief were both exterminated.
Thou hast my love. Is that not neighborly?
Her lips suck forth my soul. See where it flies. I ain't a gonna wash. I ain't a gonna wash. I ain't a-gonna wash for a week. Well, oh my goodness gracious and a golly gee, I never thought you'd get around to kissing me. But a sweet red lips just is my cheek. Now I ain't a-gonna wash for a week. Oh no, I ain't a-gonna wash for a week. I got gotta kiss some hermit, it's my lucky day. The soap and water ain't a gonna wash it away. I'm gonna keep her lips staring on my cheek. Now I ain't a gonna wash for a week, oh no. I ain't a gonna wash for a week. Oh, oh, I don't know when she'll do it again. So I'm gonna save her what I got. But oh, I promise you till then, I'm gonna protect that Well, you can call me Cookie Butter, nevertheless. I ain't a gonna wash away a single caress. You can tell me what's a little old kiss on the cheek, but I ain't a gonna wash for a week, oh no. I ain't a gonna wash for a week. I ain't a gonna wash.
He ain't a gonna wash.
No, sir, I ain't a gonna wash for a week. Woo!
Is it good news and bad news, too? How can that be?
Well, is it not good to hear that your science officer's coming?
Is she coming?
Why, no, sir.
What then?
She is coming.
When will she be here?
When she stands where I am and sees you there.
Thou still has been the father of good news.
You see? And I assure you, sir, I hold my duty as you hold your soul unto my God, that is my creator.
But do you think... Or else that brain of yours reads not the plans of humanoids so sure as it hath used to do. But you have found the secret of your master's discovery.
Uh-huh.
Oh, speak of that. That do I long to hear.
Certainly, sir. I worked on it myself. And since I am not programmed for deceit, I will relate my master's great breakthrough, which once it has but stabilized itself, will rank him with the greatest men of yore. Copernicus. Darwin. Yeah, in Einstein.
He tells me, Bosun, he hath found out the head and source of Prospero's great find.
Well.
I shall sift him.
My master. Oh, bless the hands that made my parts. He'd worked for many years in solitude upon a revolutionary idea. A form of science. Telegenesis.
Telegenesis?
Which is creation by pure thought alone, without need of instrumentality.
But that's impossible.
Creation of pure matter with a mind. To make this work, and here I use lay terms, one must open the 9/10 of the brain that ordinary mortals never use. It's called cerebral elasticity.
Cerebral elasticity?
The breakthrough came when Dr. Prospero distilled a drug he called X factor, which utilized this untapped gray matter. He took a draft while in the lab one day, and he hasn't been himself. I'm sad to say.
My robot seems to have run off at the mouth. This rolling Coke can better watch his step, or I'll be forced to take his rotor arm.
Hold your fire and listen, mister.
Sighed for. Pity move my father to be inclined my way.
Silence, my child! One more word I charge thee. Thou dost usurp the name thou owest not, and hast set thyself upon this planet as a spy to steal my formula.
No, as I am a man.
I would not be surprised if thou art not in league with Gloria, mine evil spouse.
There's nothing ill can dwell in such a temple. If the ill spirit have so fair a house, good things will strive to dwell within it.
What goes thy heart with this? Young and so untender.
So young, my lord, and true.
Let it be so. My truth then be thy dower. Here I disclaim all my paternal care, propinquity, and property of blood, and as a stranger to my heart and me, hold thee from this forever.
Golly gee. Each time we have a quarrel, it almost breaks my heart. 'Cause I am so afraid that we will have to part. Each night I ask the stars up above. Why must I be a teenager in love? One day I feel so happy, next day I feel so sad. I guess I'll learn to take the good with the bad. Each night I ask the stars up above. Why must I be a teenager in love? I the mask of night is on my face. Else would a maiden blush but paint my cheek for that which thou hast heard me speak tonight. Fain would I dwell on form. Fain deny what I have spoken. But farewell, compliment. Dost thou love me? I know thou wilt say, and I would take thy word.
Now look here, child. By innocence I swear, and by your youth. I have one heart, one bosom, and one truth, and that no woman has, nor never none shall master be of it, save I alone.
Young girl, get out of my mind. My love for you is way out of line. Let me to believe you're old enough
baby in disguise. And though you know that it's wrong to be alone with me, that's come on, look, is in your eyes. Oh, young girl, get out of my mind. My love for you is way out of line. Better run, girl, you're much too young. Too young, girl. So, adieu, young lady. Don't be sad. But can't you see that you've upset your dad?
Oh, what a deal of scorn looks beautiful in the contempt and anger of his lip. A murderer's guilt shows not itself more soon than love that seems hid. Love's night is noon. Oh, Captain, by the roses of the spring, by maidhood, honor, truth, and everything, I love thee so, that despite all your pride, nor wit, nor reason, can my passion hide.
Why must I be a teenager in love?
Why must I be a teenager?
Sitting in the clouds that sees into the bottom of my grief. You kissed my cheek. I thought you favored me, but you professed your love to the captain. Oh, Miranda. This love that thou hast shown does add more grief to too much of mine own. Love is the smoke raised with the fume of sighs, being purged of fire, sparkling in lover's eye. They vexed to a sea nourished with lovers' tears. They laugh at me, the captain and the crew. I'll be revenged on the whole pack of you.
Well, no one told me about her, the way she lied.
Well, no one told me about her,
how many people cried.
Well, it's too late to say I'm sorry.
How could I? Why should I care?
Oh, please don't bother trying to find her. She
let me tell you about the way she looks, the way she acts, and the color of her hair. Her voice was soft and cool, her eyes were clear and bright, but she's not there. Well, no one told me about her. What could I do? Huh? No one told me about her. Though you all knew, well, it's too late to say sorry. How could I know? Why should I care? Oh, please don't bother trying to find her. She's not there. But let me tell you about the way she looks, the way she acts, and the color of her hair. Her voice was soft and cool, her eyes were clear and bright, but she's not there. My goddess, to thy law my services are bound. Wherefore should I stand in the plague of custom and permit this spaceship's captain to deprive me when my dimensions are as well compact? My mind is generous and my shape is true. This is the issue of this tempest now.
Well, let me tell you about the way she looks, the way she acts, and the color of her hair. Her voice was soft and cool, her eyes were clear and bright, but she's not there.
Yeah. chance and I can find a way. Look at the bass. Shout up this temper. I grow. I prosper.
I never felt a passion so confused. So strange, outrageous, so variable. My daughter, oh, my child, my daughter, fled with the captain. That vile space wolf blow winds and crack your cheeks. Rage blow! You cataracts and hurricane all spout. You have drenched our steeples, drowned the cocks. You, sulfurous and thought-executing fires, strike flat the thick rotundity of this world. Crack nature's molds, all germins spill at once that makes ingrateful man. I am a dad, more sinned against than sinning. Oh, bless my soul, what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man on a fuzzy tree. Friends say I'm acting wild as a bug.
I'm in love.
Oh, I'm all shook up. Oh, oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, my hands are shaky and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own 2 feet. Who would be a thank when you have such luck?
Thou comest in such a questionable shape.
What says the navigation officer?
There are 2 blips upon my radar screen. The one, no doubt, our science officer.
Conveyor aerial, as you were charged.
The other, larger, monstrous in form, which travels with unwarrantable speed towards our spaceship, chasing her, I think.
There are more things in heaven and earth than I dreamt of in my laboratory.
A score of years and 10, I can remember well. Within the volume of which time I have seen hours dreadful and things strange. But this sore sight hath trifled for my knowings.
Then patch us in.
Is this
a monster I see before me, with tentacles instead of hands. Don't let it clutch me.
I see it not.
And yet I see it still.
Hath thou not fatal vision, sensible to me as to his sight? Or art thou but a monster of the mind, a false creation proceeding from the heat-oppressed brain?
Put out the force field. That will hold it back.
Ariel and the science officer are in the airlock, sir.
Open it.
Here they come. Here they come. Here they come.
It's Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Attack? Will the captain return Miranda's love? Will Prospero forgive his evil wife? Will you manage to get to the bar before anybody else? Find out this and more in the second half of Return to the Forbidden Planet.
G-L-O-R-I-A.
It's pony time! Get up! Yeah.
brief to those that can't follow the story, that I may prompt them. And with such as have, I humbly pray them to admit the excuse of time, of numbers, and due course of things, which cannot, in their huge and proper life, be here presented. Now, lest our tale jar, I will relate the story thus so far. A spaceship, on a routine survey flight, had been drawn to a planet by a force. Upon it, Dr. Prospero, the same as all the world thought had defected, lived working upon a mind-expanding drug. His daughter Miranda, a beauteous girl, has fallen for the captain of the ship, but he does not return her love. And worse, the spaceship's cook, a simple homespun lad, has got it bad for this same lovely lass. The goodly Dr. Prospero, we've learnt, has been marooned in space for many years, dispatched there by his mysterious wife, one Gloria, who, by a strange perchance, is science officer aboard this ship. Just as this fact had been discovered, the ship's attacked by some great monstrous shape. Confused? Amazed? Now, gentles, please take heart, for we will now commence the second part.
Is this a monster I see before me? With tentacles instead of hands. Don't let it clutch me.
I see it not.
And yet I see it still.
Have thou not fatal vision? Sensible to me as to his sight? Or art thou but a monster of the mind? A false creation proceeding from the heat-oppressed brain.
Put up the force field that will hold it back.
Ariel and the science officer are in the airlock, sir.
Then open.
Here they come, here they come, here they come, here they come.
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Gloria!
G-L-O-R-I-A!
Friend, once more, or close the door up with your metal head. Come, imitate the action of the tiger. Stiffen your sinews, summon up your oil. Disguise fair nature with hard fevered rage.
The earth has bubbles as the water has, and this was of it. Whither has it vanished?
Into the air, and what seemed corporal as breath into the wind. Thank God it's gone.
Were such things here as we do speak about? Or have we eaten of the insane root that takes the reason prisoner?
It was. I'm sure it will return.
But Dr. Prosper, are you okay?
Oh, do not muse at me, my worthy friend.
Ah!
I have a strange infirmity, which is nothing to those that know me.
Robot, what sayest thou?
My senses registered no organism, and yet a visual scan of yonder hull confirmed an alien presence in the ship, for which my phaser luckily drove off.
Oh, Ariel, my industrial friend Ariel.
What would my potent master? Here I am.
Now, and thy fearful phaser. Thy services did worthily perform. And I must thank you.
So must we all.
Yes, and most heartily.
But now to other business. Prospero, is this your wife? Our science officer?
This is the woman. Do thine office!
But...
Gloria, I arrest you at the suit of Dr. Prospero. Your wronged husband.
Madam, you have done me wrong. Notorious wrong.
Have I, Prospero? No.
Notable pirate! No, galactic thief! What foolish boldness brought you to my mercy, whom now, in terms so hurried and so dear, has made thine enemy?
Prospero, noble sir, be pleased that I shake off these names you give me. Gloria never yet was thief or pirate. Alas, why seest thou so?
See thyself, devil! Proper deformity shows none in the pen so horrid as in woman.
Oh, vain fool, thou changed and self-covered thing, for shame! Be monster, not thy feature.
Say no more! This woman, Captain, I pray you, mark my words, is no more than a common saboteur. My great new science, telegenesis, unlocked as 'twas by the X-Factor drug, could have transformed mankind, created things by impulses from power of brain alone. Consider, friends, the good this could perform, an end to conflict, famine, and disease.
Oh, brave new world that could be rid of these.
And she... this panacea would destroy.
We shall not spend a large expanse of time before we reckon with her several crimes. But this is just a temporary reprieve. Until that time of duty, you're relieved.
But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh, Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Ill met by starlight, proud Gloria. A miracle, your feet together.
No, I shall resist such entertainment till mine enemy has more power.
Come, obey! Thy nerves are in their infancy again, and have no vigor in them.
So they are.
So, who's sorry now?
Who's sorry now?
Right to the end. Just like that friend, when I wanted to be a friend, I tried to warn you somehow. But did she listen? Did she borrow? You had your way. Well, now you must pay. In other words,
you're so sorry now. So sorry now.
Look to the lady. And when we have the spaceship's frailties fixed, the suffering the attack, let us meet to question this most bloody piece of work to know it further. Fears and scruples shake us. In the great hand of God I stand. And thence against the undivulged pretense, I fight of treasonous malice.
So do I.
So all.
Captain Tempest, damage control report. The spaceship's hull was fractured in the attack.
Can Ariel see to it?
Right away.
I'll put a girdle around the ship in 20 minutes.
But that's not all. We're in another fix.
Another fix?
Oh, no!
Say there's more.
The Klystron generator...
No, not that.
...was overloaded, driving that thing off.
Hitch up! Let's labor to repair the ship. That monster tossed stands like a colander on this planet's pitted rocky crust. The Klystron generator must be checked, or we will lack the power to take us hence. To that end, a few words, Dr. Prey.
Cookie, take her below. Lock her away.
Now is the chance to end my discontent. Cookie, I do observe you now of late, and have not from your eyes that gentleness and show of love that I was wont to have.
Ma'am, be not deceived. I have but veiled my look. I turn the trouble of my countenance merely upon myself. Vexed I am of late with passions of some difference, which give some soil, perhaps, to my behavior.
But say, what sadness lengthens Cookie's hours?
Not having that which having makes them short. Alas, that love, so gentle in my view, should be so tyrannous and rough in proof.
He has much to do with love, but more with hate.
It is your daughter, ma'am, that I do love. Do you think that you could tell me what to do? For then, would I aid you in your desperate plight? For see, the both of us are in the wars. But if you scratch my back, I'll sure scratch yours.
Okay, Cookie. It is a deal. Let's shake. I'll tell you how to win my daughter's love. First, you must obtain the formula that Prospero developed and called... X. If you take Prospero's great mind-expanding drug, she won't think you're a dumb cluck anymore.
You think it's 'cause she thinks I'm dumb that she prefers our captain?
Right.
Now I see.
And then, my final hurdle will I jump and dispatch him to an untimely grave.
You cannot be serious. Take his life.
You want the meat, but not the butcher's knife. Was the hope drunk wherein you addressed me? And wakes it now to look so green and pale at what you said so freely?
Pretty Pete. I dare do all that may become a man. Dares to war is none. I'll do the deed.
Is it possible that on so little acquaintance I should like Miranda? That but seeing I should love her, and loving woo, and wooing she should grant? And will I persever to enjoy her?
Ah, me!
What passion hangs these weights upon thy tongue?
I cannot speak to her.
Yet she urged conference. O Captain Tempest,
thou art all o'erthrown. Miranda, all things weaker master thee.
I know something about love.
You've got to want it bad.
If that girl's got into your blood...
Go out and get her!
If you want her to be the very part of you, makes you want to breathe, Here's the thing to do. You got to tell her that you're never gonna leave her. Tell her that you're always gonna love her. Tell her, tell her, tell her. Tell her right now.
Damage report. Damage report.
Glystron generator malfunction.
Now hear this, now hear this. Damage control, maintenance crew to level 40.
Condition alpha.
Damage control to level 40, level 40.
Condition alpha, condition alpha.
I know something about love. Got to show your hand, make her see the moon up above. Go out and get this.
If you want her so, it makes your heart sing out. If you want her to, only think of you, you gotta tell her that you're never
condition
gonna
alpha.
Leave her. Tell her that you're only
condition
gonna
alpha.
Her. Tell her, tell her, tell her, tell her right now.
Over to you, Doc. Over to you, Doc. Doc, 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 Doc.
Ever since the world began, it's been the same since.
Why should true love be so complicated?
I know. Reverse polarity.
Reverse polarity.
Reverse polarity.
Well, the circuits will never take it, Skip.
Well, it's an old trick, but it might just work.
It's not logical.
Damn your logic. I've got lies to see. Reverse polarity.
Tell her.
Tell her.
Tell her.
Tell her. Tell her.
Tell her right now. Reverse polarity.
All passengers and crew, adopt polarity reversal procedure. Reversing polarity.
Come on, old girl. You know you can do it. Don't let us down now.
Overload, overload. Press harder, press harder. Reversed.
Phew! And the Klystron generator?
Klystron generator has fully operational status.
I know something about love. Got to take a hand. Show what the world made out. But this will prove it.
If you want her to be always by your side, take her hand tonight. Swallow your food.
And bend up each corporal agent to this terrible feat. Weigh and mark the time with fairest show. False face must hide, but the false heart, the low.
Prospero. 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 Wherefore art thou Prospero? It must be by his death, though for my part, I know no personal cause to spurn him, but for the general. He has the drug. How that might change his nature, there's the question. It is a bright day that brings forth the adder, and therefore think him as a serpent's egg, which hatched would, as his kind, grow mischievous and kill him in the shell. This is a man's world, but it wouldn't be nothing without a woman on this earth.
Goodness. Bosun! Bosun!
Well, what?
I have forgot. I have repaired the crack along the hull of this embattled craft. It seems your captain does know what he's at, although I sometimes wonder.
Good morrow, big boy.
Mistress! Is that you beneath that makeup and that strange attire?
So fair and foul a wench I have not seen.
It is my Ariel. Well, since I can't attract the captain with my youthful girlish charms, I thought a touch of slap might do the trick. And a frock in cosmopolitan. An ancient tome that I have read of late that shows you how to be sophisticated.
But madam, that dress will never work. For in it you miss, he'll not be hit with sexy dresses.
Honestly?
No shit. And in strong proof of chastity he's on. From such a silly boy, he lives unharmed.
What the Beetlejuice do you look like? I never saw the painting you did need. Therefore, to your face, no painting set. I found... Oh, thought I found you did excel the barren tender of the poet's debt. But now I find your charms are covered up. Shall I compare thee to a chemist's shop? Is this a vision or a waking dream? Go buy yourself a pot of cleansing cream.
Without a woman on this earth.
Oh, young budding virgin. Fair. Fair and fresh and sweet. You have no use for such unsubtle traps. I tell you, miss, and I tell you truly, too. I never saw a fresher gentlewoman. Such war of white and red in your own cheeks. What stars do spangle heaven with such beauty as those two eyes become that heavenly face?
Oh, Ariel, you are a constant friend. And for this sound advice, I do thank you. I wish the captain would make up his mind. Oh, spite! Oh, hell, I can't win either way! So, here I do abjure the love of men that only brings us most uncalled for pain. I want a robot man to hold me tight, one that I can count on every single night.
have to listen to it.
Alibis, I need a robot man to call my own. I never had to worry that he was alone. He never danced with anyone but me. I just have to wind him with my robot key. I'd have a steady day.
And got the plan. The X Factor wanted by Gloria. When she distills this mind-expanding drug, my IQ will be right up there in lights. And then, Miranda's gotta fancy me. I shouldn't have done it, but the die is cast. And to return were tedious as go o'er. Holy cow! This is a sorry sight!
What? Sorry? A foolish thought to say a sorry sight.
What vile perversions do you now perform? Against the laws of nature. And of man.
Methinks thou hast the wrong end of the stick. May I ask what you have in your hand? I think that it does not belong to you.
Mind your own business, mouth-sized cooking pot.
What?
Just keep your distance, robot. Watch your step, or I'll be forced to pull the plug on you.
Or return the formula, and I'll say naught. Or else a lesson you'll be swiftly taught.
Hey, give to me!
Well, get into that kitchen. Rattle those pots and pans. Well, get into that kitchen and rattle those pots and pans. Well, make my breakfast, cause I feel hungry.
No more Mr. Nice Guy, punk. You're gonna shake, rattle and roll. You're gonna shake, rattle and roll. You're gonna shake, rattle and roll. Hold it! Tin can? Okay. I'll beat you to the draw.
Right.
No!
No!
Oh. No! Oh, sorry, no.
Okay.
I'm sorry, sir. The formula's no more.
You stupid scrap heap! Now look what he's done. Swallowed the secret of the doctor's drug. What will we do now, metallic pest?
I read, I mark,
and I
quick, Father, help my poor deranged drone!
Oh, what's the use?
Goddamn Fang is stoned.
You blocks! He's stoned! A worse than senseless thing. My whole life's work has now gone down his throat. I will have such revenge on you both as all the world shall. I will do such things. What they are yet, I know not. But they shall be the terrors of this earth. Oh, horror, horror, horror. Tongue nor heart cannot conceive nor name thee.
What's the matter?
Oh, Captain, Captain. There is another blip upon my scanner screen. The very shape that signified the approach of that space Gorgon.
Quick, Doctor, pull yourself together, please. Your robot's phases are our one defense.
It's no use, Bose. Damn thing's OD.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
Dear Prospero, we meet again.
Put down that ray gun, madam. If you please.
No, don't do it.
Shut up, Cookie. Freeze!
Gloria no more. Begone, I say.
You are a man of sin, whom destiny that hath to instrument this other world and what is on it, which never served his face, hath caused to belch up on this planet. He's told you all, no doubt, of how I did act those many years ago back on our Earth. Of how I did set him adrift in space and put him in an orbit of no hope. The fool. The fool to think that his ape brain could contain the wonders of that marvelous drug. His true creation, telegenesis. His newfound science with no instrument. I loved him. And I warned him what would be.
Enough! Oh, Gloria, please, say no more.
You must face the truth, my Prospero. You have created monsters from the id.
What is this id? Can someone tell me, please?
Of course. It was what was once used to describe the basis of man's own subconscious mind.
Monsters? The id? I still don't see.
The X Factor released his genius brain to transmit matter where he wanted it. But he forgot one deadly danger, sir. Subconscious hate and lust for destruction.
Monsters from your subconscious.
Magath!
He knew the dangers. He created it. And though he hoped that it would help mankind, he did forget the brute subconscious mind.
The mind. The mind. It is so primitive. I have unlocked the devil in my soul and set it free to do as it would wish, to take revenge, to plunder, and to kill.
What we both knew I had to do those years ago back in our laboratory. But what I did for love. Of you, our daughter, and for children yet unborn.
It is myself that lurks outside the door. arms are all athrow, and what strength I have's mine own. Prospero now ends his tale to ensure his project fails, which was to please. Now, I want science to enforce, art to enchant, but my ending is despair, unless I be relieved by prayer. As you from crimes would pardon be, let your indulgence set me free.
We've already said goodbye. What sayest you of him now? Come, Captain, speak.
Why, ma'am, he did bestride this narrow world like a colossus. And we petty men walked under his huge legs and peeped about to find ourselves dishonorable graves. Men sometimes are masters of their fate. The fault, dear Gloria, lies not in the stars, but in ourselves that we are underlings.
Well, I'm just a soul. All alone, please don't.
beware the ids that march. Break heart, I prithee break.
Look up, my love, vex not his ghost. Let him pass. He hates him that would upon the rack of this tough world stretch him out longer.
He is gone indeed.
The wonder is he hath endured so long.
But usurped his life.
Come, let's depart. The weight of this sad time we must obey. Speak what we feel, not what we ought to say.
Yes, all the faith, virtue of my heart, the object and the pleasure of mine eye, is only yours. Oh, captain of my dreams. Fair lovers, you are fortunately met. Of this discourse we will hear more on earth. My lost one now is found. Ye gods, look down, and from your sacred vials pour your graces upon these lovers' heads.
Why, thank you, ma'am.
See how vilely they do kiss and court. Here is my hand. And here I firmly vow never to woo her more, but to forswear her as one unworthy all the former favors that I have fondly flattered withal.
You must be wise hereafter and seek for grace.
Only the Lord. There goes my baby.
There goes my heart. It's gone forever, so far apart.
Only the Lord.
We that are young shall never see so much or live so long.
The young ones, darling, were the young ones, and the young ones shouldn't be afraid to live in love while the flame is strong, for we may not be the young ones very
long.
exalted with a threatening cloud. But never till today, never till now, did I go through a tempest dropping fire. Either there is civil strife in heaven, or else this world, too saucy with the gods, incenses them to send destruction.
If you'll permit, this all seems logical. If Prospero's id created that monster, then this most beauteous planet surely is his superego.
Right? I don't understand.
Oh, sir!
Well, just as Prospero destroyed himself by committing galactic suicide, then this same planet, created as twas by his own superego, does the same!
Prepare for takeoff. Quickly we must go and put as many light years as we can between us and this self-destructive star.
We gotta get out in space.
One thing I know is true, you'll be dead before your time is through. See your daddy ever dying, watch his hair as it turns to gray. He's been slaving, working his life away. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's been working so hard. All
nine,
crew to action stations.
Eight.
Iambic
seven,
functioning.
Six.
Pentameter's
five,
locked in.
Four. Three. Two.
Hyperbole genocide.
One.
Ignition. We have liftoff.
Emergency scenario.
Almighty Father, dost thou lie so low? Are all thy conquests, glories, triumphs, spoils shrunk to this little measure? Fare thee well.
All that glisters is not gold. Often have you heard that told. Now does space his bones enfold.
Fare thee well, your love is cold. Sound drums and trumpets. Farewell, sour annoy. Here, I hope, begins our lasting joy.
Woke up this morning with light in my eyes, and then still dark outside, and it was a light coming down from the sky. I don't know who or why. Must be those strangers that come in the night. Sources shed light, get people of charge. Leave the green God grants the glory of the dark. They get home.
If we shadows have offended, think but this, and all is mended, that you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear, and this weak and idle theme, no more yielding, but a dream. Gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend. And as I am an honest bloke, if we have unearned luck now to scape the critic's tongue, we will make amends ere long, else this man a liar call. So, good night unto you all. Give us your hands. Please do feel free. Take it away!
1, 2, 3!
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye.
Thank you and good night. Thank you.
Listen, gentlemen. Most of you probably know that tonight is the last night for this present cast. So as it's rather special night for us, we'd like to take this opportunity. Usually at this point of the show, we say thank you, ask you to say thank you to some of the people who work behind the scenes, but we'd like you to do it on our behalf tonight, because the whole thing, I mean, it's a rather hackneyed phrase, but it's very true here, which I think is quite unusual for a West End theater. It's very much a team from the, you know, don't differ from the front of the box office right to the back of the backstage here, and Fraser the doorman, very much a team. So I'd like to give you a few names now, okay? And when we mention these names, we'd like to for you to look wide-eyed and hysterical, as only a forbidden old planet audience can, to raise your hands in the air and go, wow! Okay? When you hear a name, okay, you know the game. The reply's the same. So let's play. We've got Rosie!
Wow!
Beanie!
Wow!
Nikki and Matt!
Wow!
Danny and Matt!
Wow!
Scotty!
Wow!
That's right, okay. One final big one for all the boys and girls, friends of house backstage, way down in the depths, way up there in the flies and on the limes, in the box office, back here, up in the wardrobe. Everyone, folks, one, two, three, wow! That's great, thank you. Well, any of you got late buses to catch, you better go, so we're going to be here from some time now, okay?
It's
not unusual to be mad with anyone.
It's an invitation across the nation.
Thank you very much. Well, folks, looks like the end of the road. Now, we just said this is the last flight, is the present crew. But let me tell you what, we'd like a little surprise for you now. We'd like you to meet the new crew, okay? So make them welcome, okay? First, like, to introduce you to the new Prospero. Next, the new Gloria. Who's we have next? The new robot, Ariel. The new Miranda, Nina. Yeah. The new damage control. And folks, we just had, is he ready? We just had a wonderful piece of news.
Cookie.
Yeah? Yes, oh yes, again. I give up the mantle reluctantly, folks. Gentlemen, Julian Lippman, the new cookie! And we've just had some good news, that's right, Jules. That Ensign Bud Pfizer, science armaments officer, has in fact been promoted to captain. So please, folks, welcome Captain Bud Pfizer! Now, folks, keep it down here. We'd like to bring on the man who made it all possible, daddy to us all. A big, big hand, please, for Mr. Bob Carlton! Yes! What's this? What's in the bag, Bob? Oh, yeah. Julian will take good care of it for us, okay?
All right. They did it!
But you know, folks, I know there's a lot of you out there seen the show before. But you know what we rely on? You know, word of mouth. So let's keep the ball rolling. Let's keep the comet flying. You don't need us to tell you that. Carry on spreading the word, folks. Did you know all those little tips you've had? Did you read about them in the papers?
Wait, Jose.
How about CFAX? What'd you ever hear on Newsnight if it's any damn use to you?
Still joking.
We know these things are best, most informative, most valuable. If you hear it, you hear it, you hear it, you hear it, you hear it. Good night and goodbye. Thank you.
hearts are still. Did he run, run, run? Did he run, run? Somebody told me that his name was Bill. Did he run, run, run? Did he run, run?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, hearts are still.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, his name was Bill.
Oh yeah.
And when he walked me home, did he run, run, run? Did he run, run?
My. It's time to say goodbye.
Did you run, run, run? Did you run, run? Did you run, run, run? Did you run, run? Did you run, run, run? Did you run, run? Did you run, run, run? Did you run, run?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, my heart's still.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, his name was Bill.
Oh yeah.
And when he walked me home, did you run, run, run? Did you run, run?
Thank you for all your support. We wear them every day.
Thank you.
See ya.
Don't see.